The goal to open a two-way travel bubble with the Cook Islands by the end of March looks increasingly remote. Residents desperately need tourism dollars, but as our Pacific correspondent Barbara Drever exclusively reports, preparations to deal with a potential COVID outbreak have a long way to go.
For locals, New Zealand, which has always been so close, now couldn't be further away. So many hopes pinned to a free-flowing travel bubble for Kiwi tourists.
We've done quite a bit of work in positioning ourselves, firstly for maintaining we don't get COVID coming into the country, managing to contain it if it does come into the country, and being able to treat it.
One News understands only half of the work needed to open the borders has been done, although good gains are being made, like this 10-bed negative pressure ward.
If we are overflowing, we will open another one.
But the testing laboratory is some way off, with critical equipment yet to arrive. This is one of two gene expert machines here used to diagnose COVID-19, but Rarotonga Hospital will be upgrading to the PCR system that New Zealand uses. But the Cook Safe tracing tool is a step in the right direction, and the Red Cross has offered its team of 96 trained volunteers for contact tracing.
We have a well-established emergency response team. We have volunteers. We have the reach to all the outer islands.
Fears remain about COVID getting in through a travel bubble, but the failing economy is a major concern too.
Yes, we need to do something to improve the matters, the economy. But it has to be super safe. Our population is so vulnerable. Diabetes, you name it.
Our main concern really is someone coming through the borders that could be asymptomatic. But I must say that I think the risk systems have really improved since 3 to 6 months ago.
That's music to the ears of the private sector, desperate for tourists with the last to visit Rarotonga last March. The 700 rental holiday properties here are struggling to survive.
Well, we can't continue like this forever. The government will eventually run out of money, I think, because, tourism is the major GDP of the country. So we actually do need the borders to open.
The private sector has done all it can, their fate now resting with health authorities.
And the long-anticipated Cook Islands travel bubble was supposed to start before April. Barb is back in Auckland with us now. Is that any chance of happening, Barb?
Oh, it's going to take a major miracle, and they're fairly short on the ground at the moment, Simon. Look, the intent is there. Yeah, there's a lot of good work being done. The need is most definitely there. But unfortunately, there is a lot of work to be done that the New Zealand government requires, and medical work, so that the tourist bubble can open safely. And the New Zealand Ministry of Health team are there at the moment. They return at the end of this week, and we'll get a true reading of the situation from their assessment. But we're looking at several months away, I'd say.
There's another pressing issue that you've been made aware of as well.
Yes, there's a lot of Cook Islanders leaving the country at the moment. No work, no money. Of course, their passport holders are their New Zealand passport holders. So on my flight this morning, there were dozens of people heading off, young people heading off towards the South Island, to the freezing works, the fruit picking, also business owners who are just can't make a living there. So really tragic situation, and we'll have more on this in the coming days.
Pacific Affairs reporter Barbara Drever, thank you very much for that.